LeBron James. It doesn't stop, folks. The four-time NBA champion is also a four-time MVP, a four-time NBA Finals MVP. Winning a fifth NBA championship would tie him with the likes of Magic Johnson and the late, great Kobe Bean Bryant. Max, you're up first. Would a fifth NBA title give LeBron GOAT status? I'm talking MJ, Michael Jordan, his heirness GOAT status.
No. LeBron's already got the career argument. It's either him or Kareem. And I think for in the pros, in the NBA, considering how LeBron's still playing at his age, it's LeBron. Peak is Jordan. And I don't see where LeBron's going to elevate his peak over Jordan's. When we talk about greatest guys, I don't think we just mean add up all the win shares by the end of the career and who's worth more wins, right? I don't think that's what we're talking about mainly. Nor do I think it's just the guy who had one season. Oh, my God, he was all world. He was as good as anyone I've ever seen. Bill Walton or something. I don't think that's what we're talking about. We're talking about a guy who's prime, who concentrated the highest level of performance over a significant number of years. When they were at their best, like, and how long did their best last? That's the best basketball ever played, right? So in baseball, if you said who's the greatest pitcher ever, you have a very good argument for Sandy Koufax. He only had four prime years, but one after another. No one ever did it like that. I think that's really what we're talking about when we say the best who ever did it in sports. And Michael Jordan's prime. Guys, the first time Jordan played with another All-Star was Scottie Pippen. He took the Pistons 7 games. Pippen had a migraine in game 7. Scored 2 points in 40 minutes, so they lost. He never didn't win the finals again in under 7 games. Understand? Every time you gave, here, Jordan, here's an all-star, he won the finals in under 7 games and put up numbers the likes we've never seen, right? And was an all-world defender. He's the greatest of all time. I don't think LeBron can catch him.
Well, Max, you just moving the goalposts for your narrative again. You can't just say, come up with that logic and say, this is why he's the greatest of all time. Maybe LeBron James is still going. He's still at his best. Even at the age of 36, he's still at his best. And here's the problem that I have. When we talk about the game of basketball, last time I checked, the game of basketball was a team sport. This is not boxing. This is not golf. This is not tennis. Where rings and championships define your legacy? Yeah, it helps your legacy, but it don't define your greatness. How about the individual accolades? Because you could be on a team that just don't have the pieces, and you could be doing more than your part, which LeBron James has been doing his entire career. And I didn't even want to get into this GOAT debate because I already know you two old haters. I know how y'all act. Oh, no, it's nothing that he could do, not a damn thing. I'm just waiting for you, Stephen. I can't even see you today because I don't even have my monitor on. Matter of fact, I don't even want to see your face right now. But at the end of the day, I said this again. I said this before, and I'm going to say it again. I'm going to say it again. LeBron James and Michael Jordan are sitting at the same dinner table. Some people like to drink Ciroc. Others like to drink Hennessy. I'm a Hennessy type guy.
I'm a Hennessy dude. I'm a Hennessy dude. That's fair enough. And listen, stop lying, because you always love to see my face. Just stop lying. Stop lying, big boy. Stop lying. That's number one. Number two, you are absolutely right. There's nothing that's going to change my mind. To me, Michael Jordan is the greatest of all time, but him and LeBron James sitting at the same table. LeBron James is on the Mount Rushmore of basketball, one of the top four players in the history of basketball. There is no question about that. And listen, God forbid I don't say that LeBron is number one. I mean, what the greatest insult in the planet, because some of the folks in this camp, that's how they treat it. Him number two instead of number one. What blasphemy are you spewing? But I think it's something to be said about the road that you traveled to get there. I think that the things that LeBron had to endure before he ultimately got to that point psychologically, mentally, emotionally, I think there's something to be said for that. I'm thinking about the scoring championships of Michael Jordan, the NBA championships of Michael Jordan, the killer instinct that was Michael Jordan. All of those things come into consideration for me. And so when I look at LeBron, it's no disrespect whatsoever. I think he's the greatest in the game today. I think he's the greatest in the history of basketball. outside of Michael Jordan. But if I had to take LeBron at his best, and I don't hold up all those championship losses against him, even though he lost six. I don't blame him for losing to the Spurs in 2007. I don't blame him for losing to KD and Golden State. I understand what he was working against. But in the end, all I'm saying is when I take LeBron at his best and I take Michael Jordan at his best, I would want Michael Jordan every day and twice on Sunday. Over LeBron James. And that is the only person that I would want over LeBron James in the history of basketball. I don't find that to be insulting.
Stephen A's right, Perk.
Bron had to go against more Hall of Famers, but carry on, you good. Go ahead, Max.
I can use the culture of the game today compared to what it was in the 80s and stuff like that. The roughhouse tactics, the rules, how soft it's become over the years. I can bring that up. We can have that argument another time, KP. We can
do
that.
You don't want to bring up
John Hornacek and Thunder Dan again. And LeBron facing KD and Kawhi.
I'm bringing
we ain't gonna go there. You right.
Talk about
you
them.
Right. We ain't gonna go there. You right.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about basketball in the 80s. Don't act like you don't know. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Don't start that.
I can't.
You don't need to give Jordan that. You don't. For me. And so when I look at LeBron, it's no disrespect whatsoever. I think he's the greatest in the game today. I think he's the greatest in the history of basketball outside of Michael Jordan. But if I had to take LeBron at his best, and I don't hold up all those championship losses against him, even though he lost six. I don't blame him for losing to the Spurs in 2007. I don't blame him for losing to KD and Golden State. I understand what he was working against. But in the end, all I'm saying is when I take LeBron at his best and I take Michael Jordan at his best, I would want Michael Jordan every day and twice on Sunday. Over LeBron James. And that is the only person that I would want over LeBron James in the history of basketball. I don't find that to be insulting.
Stephen A's right, Perk.
Bron had to go against more Hall of Famers, but carry on, you good. Go ahead, Max.
I can use the culture of the game today compared to what it was in the 80s and stuff like that. The roughhouse tactics, the rules, how soft it's become over the years. I can bring that up. We can have that argument another time, KP. We can
you
do that.
Do not,
well, I, you, so
you
saying,
don't
you know
want to
go
there. You do not
want to
go
to the Hall of Fame.
You do not want
to
go.
You don't
want to go.
I'm so sick of the competition
because
argument.
I'm telling
it's
you, you don't want to. You don't want to bring up. You don't want to bring up John Hornacek and Thunder Dan again. And LeBron facing KD and Kawhi.
I'm bringing them up.
We ain't gonna go there. You right.
Talk about
you
them.
Right. We ain't gonna go there. You right. I ain't gonna bring up Thunder Dan. You right.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about basketball in the 80s. Don't act like you don't know. You know exactly what I'm talking about.
You don't need to give Jordan that than it was then.
You don't.